Well, growing up in Huddersfield was a really fun time, and I have a lot of good memories about Huddersfield and about Millsbridge in particular, the little town that I grew up with, the little village that I grew up in. I remember it being a very busy time. My dad wasn't around a whole lot, so he was travelling all over the country. And I don't remember him being around that much. I could be, that might be just something that's been blanked out of my mind as time's gone on. But I do remember it being a time where I was around my grandparents a lot, and my auntie in particular. And my mum, I remember a lot of fun memories, and they basically raised me. You know what I mean? As I say, it was a really fun time for me. And the locations and the place around Huddersfield and Millsbridge, it was a rural town. It was a really working class environment, I guess you would say. And one of my particular favourite memories is my grandma. My grandma, the best way to describe my grandma is like Mrs. Doubtfire. Not that she was a guy dressed up, but just she was a largish lady. And she was just a bundle of fun, and still is to this day. I mean, she's completely, cracked pot and whatever. She's just mental, but I love her so very, very dearly. And as I say, I remember her running around playing football with me, and to a 5-year-old guy, that's a lot of fun, and sitting at the bottom of the slide so I wouldn't fly off. But as a kid, I decided to slide down the slide and kick her in the hip, and now she's, I think she's now needing hip replacements and whatever else, and so is my granddad. I probably contributed to that at some point or other. So I mean, it was a really, really fun time for me. Grandparents. I remember my grandma in particular was a very strong religious lady. I was raised in a Catholic church at St. Bridget's, not far from actually where I lived, and we'd go there on a Saturday night, and I remember we'd have like the jelly babies lined up on the pew. Now, for those of you that don't know what a pew is like a church seat. It's a traditional church seat, and there were the wooden benches. And I remember a lot of priests coming in and out at that time. And I don't really remember a whole lot of what the priest was saying, but I do remember very vividly the stained glass window, especially straight at the front, and it was of Jesus Christ. And it was like a 50-foot high, just beautiful, beautiful window that depicted Jesus Christ with his hands open, almost saying, "Come on." And I loved that even from the time of a small child, because it was such beautiful colours. And I guess it impacted me, because as I'll talk about later on in this documentary, it was something that played a big part later on in my life. So as I say, I was raised as a Catholic, and went to the Catholic Church, went and made my communion, which is kind of like the religious practice in the Catholic Church. It's almost like being confirmed and being affiliated with the Catholic Church. Subsequently, when kids tend to leave a church, if one goes, quite a few, tend to disappear at times. And that's what happened at our church. I remember a lot of the youth were leaving, and there wasn't a lot of youth in the church, but those that were there were leaving the church. And I decided to follow suit and do the exact same thing. And I remember going to my gran, and I know she wasn't very happy about it. She was very much like, "Well, why is he leaving?" and everything else. I just didn't want to be there anymore. I felt I did my time, and that was it. That was it. As far as I was concerned, it was nice, but that was it. And so I left the church, over and done with. A couple of years went on, and by this age, I'm probably 11 or 12. And I developed, I would say, I don't even know how to really to describe it. I guess I developed a bit of a personality. I was just new in the school. The first year I was there, I was very quiet, very shy. The second year I was there, I started to develop more friends. Now, for whatever reason, as a child, I was very, very socially awkward. I really didn't know how to have long-term friends. For whatever reason, I really don't know. Even as a growing up as a small boy, I spent a lot of time around my dad when he was home, and we played the old NES, which was Nintendo Entertainment System for all you gamers out there. And we'd play a lot of games together, we'd wrestle together. And as far as I was concerned, if I had my dad, I didn't need anyone else. You know, and that was the way it was kind of portrayed for me, I guess. You know, my dad was like my best friend at one point in my life, and it was really special, you know, to me, that those times that I had with him, which was really,
as
really
time
cool.
went on, and as I say, as I got to be a teenager,
when I became a teenager, it became a really difficult time for me. I didn't adjust very well at all, and I kind of withdrew into myself. But when I was around people, I was the cocky, arrogant, egocentric. And I think a lot of it was for attention, but a lot of it as well was because I didn't know how to be around people. And I really, really struggled with that. And I do remember, I think that the kind of the turning point for me was in September, I think probably 2002, I want to say. I was running my mouth, you know, as I probably did, and I was like, hey, you know, look at me, blah, 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 blah. And this guy pushed me into an old boarded up windowsill inside the school. And all I remember from that was being in a lot of pain in my back. Again, at that time, I probably added, more to it than what it was in terms of, you know, making it worse than what it was. And that really didn't help me. If anything, that sent me spiraling out of control. Because of that, I got involved with taking pills. And when that, didn't seem to either get the tension or didn't seem to take away the pain that I was feeling, because there was a lot of pain going on in here, in my heart and in my head as well. And I began drinking, and that's, even today, some 12 years on, after all this has happened, that's still a really difficult thing to sit and think about, that's where addiction began for me. And I guess if I look back in my life, I've always had an addiction of some kind. And it's just that, unfortunately, that these in particular were very bad addictions to get into. As a result of that, my family and I would argue quite a lot. And I remember at one point the grandparents that I loved so much and the grandparents that loved Lisa very much not wanting anything to do with me. And that was something that, sticks out in my mind a lot. I guess just because I was so out of control. I remember my dad and I fighting a lot. And my dad struggled a lot because my mum wouldn't really back him up. In a lot of instances and a lot of arguments. And my dad really struggled with that. And I do remember incidents, for example, where he told me off, my mum wouldn't back him up. And he sat there eating cheese and crackers one night. He flips the tray and the crackers and the cheese go all over the floor and everything. And, my dad shouting at my mum and my dad shouting at me and whatever else. So that was the issue with my grandparents, and even reflecting on that, you know, as I say, 12 years on, you know, that's still something that it is difficult, and certainly with my family. But there was, as I say, it was now probably about April or May time, and I'd hit rock bottom. Everything basically I could be involved with, I was involved with. And my parents, even to this day, would still say, you know, he wasn't drinking, he wasn't doing pills, he wasn't getting up to certain activities that he shouldn't have been. The fact of the matter was, yes, I was. And, you know, Christ is very, very good at showing me these things and being very honest. And that's a huge part of our ministry. I'm not going to lie, I'm not a great mathematician, I'm not a scientist. But what I am is a vessel for God basically to tell his story through and to share this stuff with you. May 31st or May 30th, one or the other. You know, as I said, 12 years ago, I can't really remember it that well. I remember very, very vividly this incident. And I'm not to protect those that were involved, I'm not going to go into the full details. But I remember being in a fight. It was at home, and you know, it was a very horrible moment. Looking back, it was actually life changing, but it was a very horrible moment. And as I said, I'm not going to go into too much depth and detail about that. But I do remember being sent to my room because the persons that were involved were so angry. And I was so angry, and I was out of control at this point. I literally, I probably wanted to kill the person that I was fighting. And I remember just collapsing in my bed. And literally, there was stuff that was going on with me at that time, but crying out to God and just saying, I don't want to live like this anymore. I really... really don't. And unfortunately, I can't remember the exact words, but I know it was words to those effect. And that's taken me 12 years to really remember, you know, what I actually said. And from that night, Jesus Christ came into my life. I said, I don't want to live like this anymore. I need your help. And Jesus Christ came into my life. And from that night, I would speak with him daily. And it started out, I would, you know, just be like, hey, you know, how are you doing? You know, or I thank you for today, thank you for that. And I honestly believe that the 4 years before me going back to the Catholic Church, did literally the heavens of good. Not the world of good, the heavens of good. Because I was with Christ for about 4 years before I ever stepped back into the church.